Here we are in the Photoshop. First of all, create a document of 1920 by 1080. Then we'll place our background and scale it to fit the artboard. Darken the image with hue saturation adjustment layer. Then make a new solid color layer and choose any color you want. And change its blend mode to color. Invert the mask by selecting it and pressing Ctrl plus I, then take the brush tool and paint with white on one side. Do the same for the other side but with different color. Now with more solid colors, we'll make some simple glows on both sides with brighter colors. Change their blend modes to color dodge, and decrease the fill if you want. On top of that, we'll add a white solid color glow, and readjust the positions and darkness of the background layer. After that, we'll import our subject layer. Now make a new green color gradient map with these settings, and clip it to the layer below. Invert the mask by clicking on it, then pressing Ctrl plus I, and then paint green on the left side with brush tool. First paint with a hard round brush on the areas, and then make some edges softer by erasing with a soft round brush. Paint some on the body, and also on the hair as well. Now make another gradient map layer but with different color for the other side, and paint with the same method as before. Now for the bright highlights, make a new layer from here, and fill it with black, and change the blend mode to screen. Then take the brush tool, opacity and flow should be 100, and increase the smoothing from here as much as you like, then pick white color and smaller brush size, and paint like this. Don't paint on all the area, just paint less in the middle. Then take the smudge tool from here, and increase or decrease the strength according to your liking. And then spread our paint like this, it'll give the strokes pointy edges. Now just repeat this to all of the areas. First paint with brush, then spread it with smudge tool. I am doing this with mouse. There's no need for any graphic tablet for this. It's better if you have one, but if you don't, no need to worry. It can easily be done with mouse. You can increase or decrease brush size or strength of smudge tool for some of the areas. After that, I made a new gradient map with skin colors, but just a little darker and vibrant to make it more punchy. And changed its blend mode to color, and painted on the skin only. This is just an optional step. Just to give more detail, you can skip this step if you want. To give color to these highlights, make a new gradient map, and clip it to the highlights layer or group. Now here, we have negative colors, so check on this reverse box and open the gradient editor. There should be four color sliders. Black and white should remain on the sides, and two in between. The darker shade of your highlights color, and then the main highlight color here. Hit OK, and then change this group's blending mode to screen. I just duplicated the gradient map with different color for the other side. Now make a new green solid color layer with linear dodge blending mode, and decrease the fill, and select the mask and paint with lower brush flow for subtle glows. Duplicate the solid color layer and change the color for the other side, and then paint. Then some glows in the background with the same method. Then add some particles, change the blend mode to screen, press Ctrl U for hue saturation adjustment layer, check colorize box, and adjust the sliders to match the colors of the particles with our highlights. Then adjust the scaling and positioning. Also erase some areas using layer mask, then just duplicate and change the color for the green area. Then I tilted the man with all the lighting layers and made the background darker. Then I added the text and used simple gradient and clipped it to the text to highlight the words. Then added Photoshop's icon, and give it a stroke from here. Then right-click on it and choose perspective and then adjust it. Then duplicate and place it anywhere else. Give them a little motion blur from here. And then I change the text color to match with the overall theme. Then make a curves adjustment layer below the main highlights. Increase the brightness using RGB curve, and then select blue and increase it. Also go to red and decrease it, it will increase cyan. Now take the brush and paint with lower flow. Do the same thing for the other side, just increase the green this time in curves. Then I refine some areas, and added some more elements. And lastly added camera raw filter. Here's the final result. Like this video if you found anything helpful, also subscribe to Pixelit.